Hi all. So today we are sitting with one of our popular authors, Mr. Har Gobind Pant, who has recently published his book Diary of a Trillionaire in association with Invincible Publishers. So Mr. Pant, please tell us something about yourself, sir.
Thank you, Anna. My name is Har Gobind Pant and I'm very fond of introducing myself as a trillionaire traveler. Why I call myself trillionaire traveler, maybe I'll reveal it a little later.
Okay, so I would like to know about your book more. So if you could also tell us something about your book.
You see, as I said, I call myself a trillionaire traveler.
Right.
In fact, each one of us is a trillionaire and also a traveler. You know, when it comes to traveling, each one of us is traveling constantly, non-stop, at a mind-boggling speed of 110,000 kilometers per hour. Personally, I have traveled 69 billion kilometers so far and I'm still traveling. Now, during this long travel, you come across many people, you meet, you know, you learn to look at the things from different perspectives and also gather so many stories in the process. So this book, which I have put it in the form of a diary, is actually a reflection on some of these stories ranging from evolution to how we came to be on this planet Earth, how did you evolve as rational human beings. There is a chapter on Mother, and I'm talking of the Supreme Mother. The whole humanity traces its origin to one single mother. So we call her Mother Supreme or the Supreme Mother. And a few more such stories. Thank you.
So when did you first realize that you wanted to write?
You see, if I can claim to be anything, I can justifiably claim to be an avid reader. I've been reading a lot. That has been a lifelong passion. And I enjoy reading on literature, philosophy, science writing. And I've always admired good authors who write with a natural flow. And it has been a secret wish somewhere in my heart that one day I would also like to write something substantial. Although, as an educator of long experience, I've written many textbooks in Kenya and I've also contributed a few articles in magazines here and there. But this will be my first official published work which is besides the textbooks.
Right. Okay. So how long does it take to you to write a book?
You see, there is no time limit or there are no deadlines when it comes to writing something. You know, you have to catch those fleeting thoughts. Sometimes these thoughts appear all of a sudden from nowhere and there is no fixed time. And sometimes the urge to write is so strong that even you wake up at the midnight and start scribbling those notes. And sometimes the thoughts come and then you know that there is no need to elaborate on it now. You can put it in an incubator and then retrieve it later to expand. So that's how the whole process takes place. There is no fixed timeline as such, but this particular book has taken me almost 2 years to complete.
That's a long time, sir. So where did you get your information or ideas for your book?
You see, again, as I said, that we are living in such good times that at the click of a button or a click on a link, you can have, you know, access to all that information which is available, the stored knowledge and the wisdom which has accumulated for these hundreds or thousands of years. And besides that, I've also been reading a lot. So all these are the thoughts picked up from different sources and then I elaborated on those.
So what do you like to do when you're not writing?
Yes, you see, I've been an educator all my life, and reading, writing is of course a passion, but the most important thing I love most, or the thing I love most, is interacting with young people. I call them young Homo sapiens, and also I travel a lot, give motivational talks to students in schools and colleges.
Okay, that's interesting, sir. So is there anything that you would like to say to your readers?
Yes, there are many, many things. I'm say a person of my antiquity can come out with lots of things, and I might sound like a preacher, but then there are just a few basic things which I would like to tell everyone. First, food. We all know we need to take good nutrition to sustain our physical bodies. In the same way, we also need to give right nutrition to our mind as well. Good books, good reading has its own charm, and it keeps us mentally healthy and alert. Second, we need to learn to appreciate what we have and to be grateful for that. All of us are involved in our day-to-day life, mundane life, and sometimes those things which are the most essential for life, we take them for granted. But we really need to sit down and ask, what is more important? Oxygen, water, sunshine, these are essentials for life, and they are all for free. So we need to learn to appreciate these beautiful things, which we usually take them for granted.
Right.
And the third thing, which I have mentioned in one of the chapters in the book, is Ginkgo biloba. It's a complex botanical name, but it talks about the living fossils. And when it comes to the living fossils, I would like to speak a little on rigidity versus flexibility. Now, rigidity I'm using is also as a metaphor. We become very rigid in our thoughts, in our approach towards people. And just to remind people is a kind of grave reminder that rigidity is a sign of death. When somebody dies, the body starts becoming rigid and is called as rigor mortis. The doctors performing post-mortem, they can find out the exact time of the death depending on how rigid the body has become. And on the other hand, flexibility is a sign of life. So we need to decide, do we want to be rigid and dead, or do we want to be flexible and alive? In fact, being alive means being more flexible. And at the moment, if we look around ourselves, even on a global scene, most of the problems are there because of the rigidity. If every one of us learns to be a little flexible, approach others with that kind of understanding, and also appreciate others' viewpoint, I think it will become a wonderful place to live.
Wonderful, sir. Thank you so much for coming here and taking out time for this. And I would like to ask people to please buy your copy of Diary of a Trillionaire. It will be available on Amazon, Flipkart, Kindle, and also on various bookstores. So please do buy the book and leave your reviews. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And dear readers, welcome to this book. Welcome to The Diary of a Trillionaire Traveler. I hope you would enjoy reading some of those stories. Thank you very much. God bless you.